And now I'd like to introduce someone who is sitting where you are just 1 year ago, actually, and she is already setting the world on fire. Recipient of the second annual Distinguished Graduate Award, Dr. Dalia Ruiz.
Good afternoon. Buenas tardes. First, I'd like to take a moment to congratulate all the graduates here today, because despite the tremendous challenges and obstacles with which they are faced, these students persevere to make their dreams a reality. To my Latino graduates here, let me stand before you today be a testament que si se puede. And do not be afraid to dream beyond today. I'm quite honored and humbled to stand before you today as a recipient of this year's Distinguished Graduate Award. I wish to thank Dr. Nancy Leffert and the entire committee for selecting me as the winner. I would also like to give a special thank you to Dr. Salvador Treviño. Nominating me and for having been a mentor and a source of motivation during my time at Antioch. We are only as good as those around us, and the Antioch community has a collection of talented colleagues and teachers who are truly inspirational and for whom I have the deepest respect. From the first psychology course I enrolled in at the local community college, which ignited a passion to learn more about the study of human and mind, the road to my quest has been long. There have been many sleepless nights full of homework, daunting class assignments and readings, numerous applications to educational institutions, internships, and job placements. I have fallen, I have failed, I have faced several challenges along the way. But each one has only served to strengthen me and be better at each. In the first stage of the doctoral student and the application process, it was Antioch's mission to provide learner-centered education and to empower the students with the knowledge and skills to advance social, economic, and environmental justice, which resonated with me. I found my experience at Antioch to be profoundly growth-evoking, affirming, and in harmony with my own concerns for social engagement and intellectual development. As a postdoctoral psychologist entering the professional workforce, I reflected on the needs of our world, and it was my belief that education was at the heart of all resolutions. After receiving two associates, a bachelor's, a master's, and a doctorate, I thought I had concluded my education, but I was wrong. I'm not finished. You see, John McCormick once wrote that being an educated person is not only about your career. Being educated means realizing that there are more important things out there than your personal hopes and dreams. Those degrees on the wall don't actually change the world. Sorry, guys. They do, however, demonstrate my devotion and passion for learning, a passion for advancing knowledge, and a commitment to empowering others. Since my graduation 12 months ago, I have completed my postdoctoral hours and I'm currently working towards licensure and towards opening a private practice. I presented the treatment model I developed as part of my dissertation for treating Latino childhood trauma to my local school district, and have recently been contracted to implement this treatment approach throughout the local high schools this coming fall. I have been training with physicians for human rights to be able to provide pro bono forensic assessments to undocumented minors in the Texas detention facilities. And I have had the privilege of researching and presenting on various topics around the world, including the Inter-American Psychology Conference in Peru, the World Congress of the World Federation for Mental Health in Egypt, the International Conference on Spirituality and Psychology in Thailand, and the upcoming International Conference on Developmental Psychology in Mexico. Latino mental health is an area of interest and one which I plan to continue to research and work towards advancing. Toni Morrison, an American novelist, editor, and professor at Princeton University, tells her students that when they get the jobs that they have so brilliantly trained for, they must remember. They must remember that the real job, if they are free, is to free someone else. If they have some power, then their job is to empower somebody else. I share her sentiment, and I have made it my mission to work towards freeing and empowering others through raising awareness and education and being a voice for those who do not have one. I am open to see when, where, and how I can do my part to harvest power. I don't know where my life will take me or what opportunities I may receive, but I am confident that Anna has given me the needed skills and knowledge base, and I hope that whatever my small accomplishments will be, they will continue to reflect well upon this university. I would like to end with a personal thank you to my family who's here today for their continued love and countless words of encouragement through the years. This profession has been one that requires dedication and hard work, and their faithful support has made this and all other accomplishments possible. Thank you.